Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and he now enriches you and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. So in the presence of the church, I ask you now to state your name. Andrew and Sarah, you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage. Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I invite you to come forward, join your hands, and declare your consent before God. Humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined. enjoy today the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Sarah, and upon Andrew, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly, and bear witness to you in the world, and after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, they may come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. Sorry.
Congratulations, you two. Have a wonderful life.
Congratulations, Andy and Sarah. Congratulations.
Got any good words for the bride and groom, Gerard?
Congratulations. We're thrilled for you.
I second that. Congratulations.
Second that. Say something good to the bride and groom.
Hey, Andy and Sarah. Congratulations.
All the best.
All the best to you. Best wishes.
Talk.
Hi. Congratulations.
Peg.
Happy wedding.
Cheers. Cheers to the bride and groom. Yes.
So start talking. Something to the bride and groom.
Well, bride and groom, we've been married almost 35 years, and we wish you the same wonderful, at least 35 years of wonderful bliss in your life. Best wishes and congratulations to you.
Take 1 year at a time and don't go to bed angry.
Have a great life.
Congratulations.
Wishes for the bride and groom.
Congratulations, Andy and Sarah. We're excited for you. Welcome to the family, Sarah. We love you.
Everything she just said, I actually told her to say all that. So
you scripted it for her?
I did, actually.
Note.
Well, let's see. I'd love to wish both Andy and Sarah a long and happy life.
Congratulations, guys. Have a wonderful life and a wonderful marriage and all the best.
Hey, congratulations, everybody look good up there. Very good up there.
And we look good out here.
Absolutely.
By the girlfriend, Alex Braun. Let's give them a hand. All right, let's give a big hand to Shay and Andrew. Let's give them a hand. All right, now, stand up. Stand up, get up, get up. I need you to put your hands together and make a lot of noise for the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Andy Braun. All right, you may be seated.
Thank you all for coming. We really appreciate it. And I don't think either of us can tell you how much it means to spend all of this time with you and have, you know, be able to protest in front of God and all of you, because that's what it is. It's a commitment between all of you and God and us that we are going to make this work. And I mean what I said in my vow, always.
Yeah, so we'll try to follow that up, I guess. We do want to thank you for making the effort to come out here. It's a very important day for us, and we're very glad that you can spend it surrounded by all of our friends and family. So very heartfelt thanks to every one of you who came out.
All right, where is Nathan McConnell at? We're going to have a blessing, and then I'll tell you how food is going to happen.
And so she was a young little girl. And so it's so beautiful to actually see you grow up and get married. And Andy, I don't even know you. But I do know this, that when we were on a holiday in North Carolina, a lot of the conversations were actually about you. And so I feel like I know you. So I want to pray over this meal, but I also want to pray over you.
We've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we miss. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. The years, you never let me down. You turned my life around.
Well, first of all, I want to thank everybody for coming. I know everybody came from long distances to get here and witness this event, and thank you very much. So I want to start off with a story that neither of you know.
Good.
Oh, that's not good. I like this.
And it's an apology.
Oh, okay.
It's an apology to Andy. Okay? All right? And I'm a dedicated computer gamer. And there's this game called Civilization that is very addicting. And you have to play one more turn. There's support groups for it. All right, and I love that game. And so in 2006, a new edition came out, and this big tall guy was always in my house. All right, and he had eyes for my daughter. And so I hatched a plot that, you know, maybe if I gave him this game. Divert his attention from my daughter, okay? So one day he was kind of watching me play. I said, do you want to sit down? No, I don't. And I said, oh, Andy, it's a great game. And I went to my closet, I opened up, got a brand new copy. I said, here, Andy, take this. Might enjoy this game, okay? Now, Andy took it and he played it. But in his Andiness, his Boy Scout, Eagle Scout Andiness, he was able to appropriately balance attention to Sarah, attention to the game, and attention to his studies. But you never knew there was an ulterior motive for giving you that game. And I think you introduced Alex and maybe Kyle to it.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah. But now, I'm glad it didn't work. Okay, and I'm glad you're here, and you're my son-in-law, and we all witnessed the wedding today. And, you know, I started to reflect a little bit on the wedding, and I thought, you know, this thing has been planning since October 2012. And there have been thousands of hours of time that has been invested in that, and hiring contractors, signing contracts, finding locations, ordering flowers, just, and then all of you spent tons of time to book your reservations, to travel here, and then for sure, there's the money. You know, all of this is expensive. And so, you know, I was reflecting why. For something that took an hour, right? It was only an hour and a half. With other churches, it takes 15 minutes. theirs took an hour. But for something that is so short, why as a society do we invest so much in it? And the answer to that is very simple. It's extremely important in God's plan for mankind, right? And this is a miracle. You guys witnessed a miracle today that God put in place. And it was two families, the Bruns and the Arbuthnots, came together and spawned a new family. And they will go and spawn families. And this is what's been happening for generations, for years. And today we heard Sarah take Andy, and Andy take Sarah. But there was another commitment in there that you guys didn't actually accept. You accepted Andy, Sarah, but you turned down the other 3 billion men on this planet. All right? Andy, you turned down the other 3 billion women on this planet. Because the two of you are going to stay together for life. And that's a great thing. And now for my last little story. Okay? And this was we noticed early on in this relationship that Andy and I had a lot of similar traits. Okay. All right. And we used to tease Sarah that she was marrying her father. Now, there are a few that aren't. I'm not a runner. Okay. Never have been, never will be. Okay, but it was amazing. There were a number of traits that were very similar. The first time this happened was when they were just dating, and Teresa and I were talking, and Teresa said to me, "You gotta watch that man. He may not tell you the whole, he'll never lie to you, but he'll never tell you, he may not tell you the whole truth." And when you said that, I didn't say anything back to you, but you know what hit me? I said, "That's exactly the way I was." And you can ask my mother over there. And she the exact word out of her mouth I've heard numerous times, okay? We're both chemical engineers. We both love science, math.
Both love me.
Okay. And then two times, I was with Sarah and her mother. We were eating. They brought some bread out that... They brought some bread out, and there was nothing to cut it with. I pulled out my pocket knife and cut it. And you could see this expression on Sarah's face. I said, "What's up?" She said, "I was eating with Andy last night, and he did that exact same thing." And then the crowning one was she came in one time, and she said, "Do you know what Andy's favorite Christmas carol is?" And I looked at her and I said, "Carol of the Bells, because that's mine." And she said, "Yes." Well, Sarah, as I was thinking about this, I came up with one more thing, okay? Andy and I both love you immeasurably and unconditionally. And that is going to go a long way for you and you guys. We love you greatly. And let's all raise to them. And then I think I'm turning this over to Alex.
Thank you to Mr. and Mrs. Arbuthnot for throwing me the love of the wedding and having us all here. Thank you. All right, I would first like to start off by saying congratulations to both you and Sarah. And I wish you all the best as you continue to progress through life hand in hand. Although what was a little concerning was yesterday at the rehearsal dinner, you questioned Father Todd about which candle to blow out. Shouldn't that be rather obvious not to blow out the unified candle? I wish you guys all the best. Sarah, officially, welcome to the family, and that's been in the works for a while. When Andy first asked me to be his best man and told me that I could give him a toast, and even in the moments leading up till now, a little worried and concerned about what I would say. Because Andy's very careful about what he does. At the same time, I was also very taken back by the trust and pride that Andy had placed within me. I would say that it might even contend with the pride that I felt that after 15 years of being called Munchkin, I finally became called Andy. Andy and I have a very healthy brotherly bond that is characterized by a few different things. Playful routine and comedic shots at each other.
competition about anything you can think of, and many memorable moments ranging from stuffing thousands of goodie bags for MS Walks and sticking out with the biggest sword bumps at rock concerts. The truth of it is that we've had many memorable moments, countless of them, and there are too many to just recollect. But in all of these moments, I've always cherished my time with you as my brother, best friend, and my role model. I wish you guys all the best, and at this particular time, I would like to do something a little strange, but and something that I might regret in the moment. I'm gonna give Kyle the mic. But before I do, a toast to Andy and Sarah that they may live long, happy, and prosperous lives together.
Yeah, you guys get to hear me talk. Hello everyone, I'm Kyle, Andy's little brother. I just want to say that one of the things Andy loves most about me is my love of puns. So anyway, congrats to you, Andy and Sarah, especially you, Sarah, because with your marriage, you get a new name and a dress. Congratulate everyone who was involved in the wedding. It was very emotional. Even the cake was in tears. Finally, I know Sarah is always the apple of Andy's eye, and he likes to sit down and be excited. That was the last one. I just want to say personally that Andy, you're a really good brother. I'll miss you as you go on, but thank you for everything.
Insatiable appetite for Thomas the Tank Engine. If you guys remember,
The tape is like burned into my head. Anyhow, he loved that. And then later on, it was Toy Story. And as he got a little bit older, he was involved in baseball and played basketball and lots of soccer and got involved with the Boy Scouts. And he had all kinds of interests and all kinds of activities. And then he went on to high school, and he took on one other really primary interest. And she's standing right here.
All right, now you can cut.
Get light.